Carol, we're going to take a quick breather, but I'd like to ask you, is it too late? Is it ever too late to start making those changes?
Absolutely never, ever is it too late.
Now, this is slightly aside, but I'm just curious. I'm following what's happening around the world. It's not looking great, let's be honest. Let's put realistic about it. You know, they're saying the end of the world as we know it, the end of capitalism, maybe, you know, the nationalisation of banks and all these sort of things that are happening. It's a massive transformation of what we know and the structures that we know that have been in place for years and years and years. Carol, what is the new company going to look like? What's the new dynamic? How are people going to be changing that shift towards massive corporations, thousands of people employed? I'm just slightly curious, as if we can, not wanting to sort of look into a crystal ball of such, but just to get your idea or thought about sort of the upcoming or new trends for the future, to give people an inkling or as to how to manage and what to do now, to make the changes now for the possible future.
I think that, just go back to, the end of the world is not nigh. We're going through challenging times, and as of all challenging times, we will come out of it. We've been through wars, we come out of that with the learning and the experience, the learning experience that comes with that. So we need to move on. Industry needs to move on. The two words I gave before the break were attitude and mindset. They absolutely need to be for the future. The attitude and mindset that we had for the past may actually not work for the future, and they may not. And so therefore they may have to call on the experts who've actually done this before, who've actually moved their attitudes, who've moved their mindset, who've actually said, we have been through this, maybe not identically, but it doesn't really matter. But this is what we did. This is what worked. And this is what didn't work. And that's okay as well, because let's learn from what the things that don't work as well. So that's really important. So we have to move on with that. Are things going to be different for the future? I would say if ever there was a time to start looking at key people and what they're bringing and managing those key people, it is absolutely 100% now and no question of that, because we can't manage without them. And if we lose them in our businesses, do you know something? They'll go somewhere else. And they'll go somewhere else where they do, when they are valued and they are respected and they are needed. And they do feel this simple thing like sense of worth.
Mm.
And when we feel a sense of worth, and I mean that's a feeling rather than just being told, when you feel a sense of worth, that's actually where you want to be. And I'll get in there extra early and I'll stay extra late. So industry needs to value those people and bring in that as a concept. There's a philosophy here that we're talking about. The philosophy is to manage people and to manage, you know, your processes, we say, coming back to that, are irrelevant if you don't manage what's coming out of that after that. So it's managing your people, get the most out of them, retain them. They will carry you through. Involve them. Take them through the challenging processes that you're going through. Why not? This isn't all just about everything being fantastic. We are going through difficult times. Bring everybody in together. Let's talk about it. Let's have team briefings. Call them whatever you like. It doesn't really matter. But we'll probably call it an engaging lunch hour. It doesn't matter what it is. Mm. But actually bring people in so they all feel a part of this. And you know, saying, when I feel included and I'm actually a part of what's going on, I'll give more. I'll work harder and I'll say, do you know something, guys? You are the greatest company for me to work with. And I know you're not paying me a dirham extra. I know that. But that's how we have to get to some of these simple things. And it's a bit like people eat food behind their desk. Scrub all that. Stop all that. Get your canteens out again. Get people communicating. Get people sitting around a table, actually chatting. Dare I say, actually talking to each other. Not sending an email and saying, hello, did you have a nice weekend? And I'll send that to you. And you're only across the
but
desk.
But isn't this a kind of, aren't these the kind of corporate values or corporate cultures that, in fact, were almost scrapped or left by the wayside as we so-called advanced into the future? Are you saying it's sort of a call upon old values or going back to the way that we used to work before?
I'm not saying go back to the way we used to
work. I'm not saying
before.
Going back as
couldn't,
in...
couldn't imagine
as in,
life without my computer.
I think the word community comes
that's
to mind.
Word,
offices, offices have stopped being communal spaces where we really care about one another. We respond
hot
to the
desks and all
we
this.
Respond to the fears of the manager who we know is, you know, like scared about his job, blah, blah, blah. But I have a question.
Very, very briefly.
Yeah, very
we've
quickly.
Got like 30 seconds.
What about the people that have to go? With your experience, what is it that they hold on to in terms of self-respect?
They have to hold on to the fact that the world is changing. They need to get their attitude and mindset. They need to not take it personally. They have to move on to a business that is actually right for them as a human being and not just take a job, hopefully, just for the sake of taking it. The word community is right. Build your communities for the future of 2009 and thereafter. I 100% back that, support that, and that would be my philosophy.
Thank you very much. Great to speak with you. Great to have you on the show. Carol Spears. All the very best to you.